Welcome back to Hannity. The Council on American-Islamic Relations, better known as CARE, has launched a massive letter-writing campaign calling on Israel to end its military offensive in Gaza. Now, in a press release, the pro-Muslim organization said in part, quote, the U.S. government must not remain silent about Israel's unjust and disproportionate use of force against the Palestinians in Gaza, because American taxpayers provide Israel with billions of dollars of aid each year. We have a right to demand that those funds not be used to take the lives of innocent civilians. Now, interestingly enough, there was no mention of the terrorist group Hamas and their role in this conflict. After all, they started this conflict. So my question is, why is America's largest Muslim so-called civil rights group showing sympathy to terrorists? Here to debate this from the American Islamic Forum for Democracy, Dr. Zuhdi Jasser is with us. And also joining us, the executive director of the Jerusalem Fund and Palestinian Center in Washington, Yousef Munayyer is with us. Welcome all of you. Thanks for being here. Yousef, let me ask you this. If I fire 1,600, 2,000 rockets into your neighborhood, I kidnap three children in your neighborhood, students, and I kill them. What do you think the proper proportionate response is?
Well, maybe you should stop the ongoing, for decades long, military occupation of Palestinian territory.
Okay, listen, we can take it back to the 1948 partition plan, and we can look at the 67 war, the 73 war, and the hostilities abroad to Israel. They did give land for peace 9 years ago. Now I'm asking you a question. If thousands of rockets are fired in your neighborhood, what, and kids in your neighborhood are kidnapped, what are you going to do?
Sean, if what the are United you gonna States... Do? Sir, I'm going to try to answer your question if you
Good
stop
answer.
Badgering me. Thank you. If the United States was invaded by a foreign military and besieged and surrounded, and the food that was coming into the United States was counted by the calories so that people would be put on a diet, as the Israelis claim.
Bombs were being dropped.
Sir, let me finish.
You're justifying...
You
are making a rationalization for rockets and kidnapping and murder, and you expect you want to blame the victims in this case. Zuhdi Jasser.
The only people blaming the victim here is you, because there
Yousef,
are countless Palestinian civilians.
Yousef, this cycle of lack of... Yousef, we can't continue to explain these things away. For crying out loud, it's Ramadan, and they continue to send rockets out, and organizations like CARE, who, by the way, the FBI, by matter of policy, will not interact with because of the fact that they won't condemn Hamas as a terrorist organization. And as still to this day, they will not recognize them because of that. So they, just like hitting a softball...
All right, Yousef, I have a question.
Hamas launches, let me finish, Hamas launches rockets on innocents, starts a war after war, and then they use that to say, well, it's a bigger narrative, it's about the occupation. Meanwhile, they have a gender apartheid inside Gaza. Christians are evacuating because churches are being burned. Their doctrine is fascist and genocidal against Jews. Palestinians aren't represented by Hamas, I don't believe, and yet they allow Hamas to drive the narrative globally and start wars.
I want to ask Yousef a question. Is Hamas a terrorist organization?
Do I get to actually speak now?
You get to answer the question. It's a simple yes or no question.
You invited me on here as a guest.
Is Hamas, whose charter calls for the destruction of Israel, is that a terrorist organization? That's a yes or no question.
Thank you for your question.
Now
I will provide an answer.
Finally.
It's very telling to me. And it should be telling to your viewers as well, by the way, that the moment you have a Palestinian voice on your program who begins to explain the legitimate grievances of Palestinians on the ground, Am I a guest on your program or am I on a witness stand here?
Is Hamas a terrorist organization?
The United States certainly considers Hamas a terrorist organization.
I asked what you think.
Okay.
Can you hear?
Look, if you think that we are going to have any progress in this situation by simply yelling at me, let me ask you a question, sir.
Is Hamas? What part of this can't you get through your thick head?
Is Hamas a terrorist organization?
Yes or no?
I already answered your question.
Yes or no?
I already answered your question.
You did not.
Well, this is the problem, Yousef, is that we cannot. Why is he asking you if it's a terrorist organization? Because terrorist organizations use children as shields, launch rockets into civilian populations, start a war that victimizes the poor children that are being killed in this war. And just like when America had to go into Afghanistan, had to go into Iraq, we saw pictures from CARE and other organizations saying America is killing innocents, when in fact we were fighting a legitimate war that had unfortunate deaths that happened. And this is about, if you want to stop the deaths of children, stop the firing of rockets.
You had your chance. You didn't say Hamas is a terrorist organization. Goodbye.